Hello everybody, and welcome to a new series with Ragemore on the Wife Aggro channel. I decided that I wanted to play through some of the storylines of Star Wars The Old Republic, one of the games that I feel has one of the best story kind of single player modes within a multiplayer game. And I thought this would be a great little series to throw up and just have you tag along on this tale. So in this, I will try to pretty much go story mode. I'm not going to do a lot of commentary. I think what really kind of prompted me doing this series is I've been watching The Clone Wars on Netflix recently, and it got me thinking that this game was so good when I originally played it that I should come back to it. Now, it's probably been more than 6 months, maybe a year, since I have been in it. It's been through the whole free-to-play changeover and some expansions and some downloadable content, and all kinds of things have been added since I stopped playing. So I'm going to come at this from a very fresh perspective, as if I'm brand new, and I'm going to go ahead and have an adventure in Star Wars The Old Republic. I'm going to not talk through most of the story elements. Any of the talking I do during the series should be in character, and we're going to go ahead and create our character first for the person that we're going to have this little adventure with. Now, I have played the Galactic Republic up through with a Jedi. I believe they were a counselor, I think was the name of it, and they were one of the Jedi type because everybody's got to have a lightsaber. I have thought in this one I would try going through the Sith Empire and play through the kind of the Empire storyline, but I haven't really decided what character I wanted to play. So, let's go ahead and take a look. So it looks like we have several things here, and just in the beginning I'm going to try to give you a little bit of idea of my thinking. We'll talk through some of this. Hopefully the music isn't too loud in the background for this. So we have the Sith Warrior. No one inspires more fear than a Sith warrior born for battle. Few opponents can withstand the rage-fueled blows from a warrior's lightsaber or penetrate a warrior's armor. If dual-wielding lightsabers can't finish the job, there's always Force Choke to bring an opponent to his knees. I'm a huge fan of Force Choke. That's a cool move. Let's see what else we have. Sith Inquisitor. So here, where a Sith warrior is rage, an Inquisitor is cunning. A master of Force Lightning and arcane secrets, the Inquisitor can hold one enemy in the air and stun another, all the while attacking with lightsaber moves designed for maximum pain. So those are the two kind of anti-Jedi, I guess, or equivalent to the Jedi classes. There's two sets, different types of lightsabers I assume they will use. Then we have the Bounty Hunter. Thorough professional, the Bounty Hunter trains mind and body for every possible job. Blasters, flamethrowers, missiles, energy shields, jetpacks, and the best armor money can buy. The name of the game is preparation and versatility. So here we have the Bounty Hunter. And finally, we have the Imperial Agent. Behind every Imperial surprise attack, sabotage, all the great betrayals, was an Imperial Agent. Armed for stealth and assassination, agents do the jobs nobody else can, and as such are trained to use everything from sleeping darts to sniper rifles, stealth belts and knives to advance probe droids. So that's pretty interesting. I think I'm leaning towards these two, mostly because in the Clone Wars, the show has a really good kind of mix of showing, obviously, Obi-Wan and Anakin and some of those things, but it also has a pretty good focus on the clones themselves. You get to see some of the different ones. You get to see some of their storylines, and some of the episodes that I've watched so far, it's mostly been about a clone, you know, at certain points. Not always and not in every episode. And I've only started watching the very first season. Since it's on Netflix, I'm going to be going through it, and that's been kind of the inspiration for this series. And so I think I'm leaning towards kind of the unsung heroes, the people in the background that are around when people are doing things and powers are moving and strategies are happening. Whereas I think the kind of the Sith or the Jedi are more of the big movers and shakers. And they seem to be the obvious class of obvious power. I think I like the idea of a storyline between either the bounty hunter or the Imperial agent. So in this case, I think maybe we'll go Imperial agent, and this is just because this is kind of the equivalent of the clone on the Rebel side. Now, I don't think the timeline for the show and the game is the same. In fact, I'm going to have to look up, which I probably should have done before I even started recording, where the timeline is, and maybe I'll go ahead and bring that in and give us an idea of that. So give me just a second, and I will be right back. All right, so just to give you a little history here that I was reading. So the game itself is taking place over 3,000 years before the rise of Darth Vader. So this is going to be quite a bit, 3,000, three millennium, I guess, before we would see Anakin at all, which is in the Clone Wars, which is inspiring me to do the series. Just to give us a little bit about this, in case you don't know about it. So, protected by the legendary Jedi Order, the Galactic Republic stood as a bastion of peace in the galaxy for thousands of generations. Several centuries ago, the greatest threat the galaxy has ever known emerged in the form of the Dark Sith Empire. After a volatile war, the Republic emerged victorious and the Sith were assumed to be extinct. Nonetheless, the Jedi have maintained a constant vigil over the ancient Sith homeworld Korriban to protect the galaxy from the darkness that still resides in the planet's tombs. Though a small group of survivors escaped to warn the Imperial invasion, it was only a minor reprieve from the Republic. Korriban was one of several worlds to fall in the initial onslaught, and in the years that followed, the Republic suffered many more painful defeats. Emboldened by their numerous victories, the Empire soon moved to conquer the core worlds, luring the Republic fleet out of position and launching a surprise attack against the noble world of Alderaan. The courageous stand on Alderaan rallied the spirits of Republican defenders across the galaxy, but the balance of power remained in the Empire's favor. This only fueled the surprise felt when the Imperial Dark Council extended the offer to Republic to engage in peace negotiations. Suspecting possible treachery, Republic officials agreed to meet on Alderaan, but insisted that the Jedi Order marshal all its resources to provide comprehensive security. The Jedi complied, sending most senior members of the Order to Alderaan and leaving only a token force in the Temple of Corsican. After destroying the Jedi Temple and overwhelming the Republican defenses, Imperial forces occupied Corsican. Holding the planet hostage while negotiations restarted on Alderaan, with the capital at stake, Republic officials had little choice but to agree to the Empire's terms. The Treaty of Coruscant was signed, forcing the Republic to cede control of several star systems and to acknowledge new boundaries of Imperial dominion. Though the treaty brought about an official end to the war, tensions between the two sides have remained high over the last several years, and now a return to open war seems all but inevitable, which is where we pick up. So, let us continue creating our little Imperial agent. And moving on to the next step. And hopefully I didn't sit on the screen too long to have timed out. So in this case, we have select the species you wish to be. It looks like I can be human. I can be cyborg. Or Zabrak, I think. I could be butchering that name. And some of these other ones are locked because I believe because of the free-to-play piece, I would have to unlock them. So, in this series, I plan not to spend any money, so this will be a free-to-play series. And what sounds pretty good? That feels a little too Sith-like to me. Human seems a little too plain, maybe. So cyborg. I think we'll try cyborg. And I don't think it matters which you choose. So in this case, male or
I'm
female.
I'm a loyal servant of the Empire.
Or I think I can go back one.
I'm a loyal servant of the Empire.
Alright, I think we'll go there. So, let's see what happens with random. Yeah, look at this dude. I'm digging it. let's try another one. So we got big dudes, little dudes, skinny dudes. Muscly. There's all kinds of stuff you can do here. So what would an Imperial agent look like? I think we can go with something like that. I guess I'll make my own here. Seems a little unkempt. Alright, so if I go with the next body type, oh, he's a pretty big dude. It's like the Captain America guy before he turns into Captain America. No, I think we just like normal. Nothing too crazy. All right, random name. Frednerilli. Got to be something I can try to pronounce. Rima. Nintendo. Almost like Nintendo. Nintendo. Wasn't quite good enough. Vugolt. Withko. Something will jump out at me. Wamego. Usually I find one by now. So we could do that. Lankard. Maybe the V is silent. Or I could say Vatcard and the L is silent. I like it. Let us play. Alright, so from here on out, we've created our character of Vatcard, the Imperial agent who is a cyborg. Let us begin on his story.
Secure transmission established. This is Keeper. We may speak freely, Agent. Prepare to receive your orders.
I'm ready, sir. What's the assignment?
In short, subversion. You were chosen for this operation because of your exemplary performance during training. Imperial Intelligence needs agents capable of working independently in the field. Now you apply your training to the real world. Nemro the Hutt and his organization run Jaguna, and you're in town to convince Nemro to supply the Empire.
Give me background. What are we working from?
Jaguna is an industrial town, and Nemro runs most of the industry. The Hutt plies weapons, drugs, and raw materials, but not to us. We believe Nemro has been reluctant to lose Republic customers by publicly siding with the Empire. It's time he overcame this reluctance.
By force, or did you have another method in mind?
It's too early to say for certain. We need to know what Nemro and his advisors are thinking before we can act. I want you to obtain access to the Nemro clan's inner circle. You'll require a cover identity. One of our contacts, an alien named G, has prepared a background for you and will provide the details.
How do I find him?
Jig will be waiting for you at a safe house. Locate him, take what he offers, then report to me.
Are we sure this contact is trustworthy?
Jig won't betray us. Whether he succeeds at his assigned tasks is another matter. I'd be more concerned with the rest of the populace. Most of Jaguna is caught up in a turf war. Some of the gangs involved belong to the Hutts. Others are independent. Your combat training should see you through, but expect brutality and expect to be targeted. Jaguna isn't friendly to strangers. Now, find Jig and report back to me. Keeper out.
State your destination. All vehicles leave on time.
Atrodo normales. Smogas total gis bavo apiatai.
I'm listening. Continue.
Vataranai ango mis akananon alas protas era. Gratai aptikte irprit virtini savasia savebe caegis.
If there's another red blade out there, won't that be a problem?
Smalsio poputus mana ira patare mananan kali. Vataranai ango mis akananon alas protas era.
I'm not going to like this, am I?
Carpejo pargi. Atrodo nomales. Smogas total gis bavo apiatai. Gratai aptikte. Irprit virtini savasia savebe caegis.
Let's make this fast and quiet, then.
Atrodo nomales. Smogas total gis bavo apiatai. Vataranai ango mis akananon alas protas era. Siotaisek la prasma era. Abra vimos brandimus prostis cad atavere dag.
What exactly are these gifts?
Gratae aptite irprit virtini savasia salvebe caegis. Vataranae angomis acananon alas protas era.
Jig, from this point forward, operational security will be at a premium. You will not contact us from this terminal again.
Smalsio poputus mana ira patare mana nan kali.
I understand you corrected Jeeg's mishandling of the situation, Agent. We'll now proceed.
Acknowledged and understood.
Your next task is to access Nemro's inner circle. Present yourself to the hut as a fellow gangster, the Red Blade, and offer him Jeeg's gifts. One of the gifts is implanted with a listening device, which we will use to monitor conversations within Nemro's palace.
If someone suspects me, what should I do?
Use your judgment. Silence them or allay their suspicions as appropriate. But keep this in mind. At this juncture, our primary goal is to find weaknesses in Nemro's organization. Even if the Hutt won't join us, we might influence his lieutenants. Talk to Nemro and his men. Determine who we can turn and how we can sway them. We will be listening.
In that case, I'd better watch my mouth.
I expect my ears can handle it, Blade. Be careful what you say. And lose the accent. When you're in the Hutt Palace, you're no longer an Imperial. Contact me from the cantina once Nemro has his presence. Keep her out.
We are not responsible for missed departures. There are others waiting. Move along.
The pirate's on his way. Security droids say he's armed, but he won't be trouble.
Let's hope not. Here he is now.
I'll go tell the boss.
This is Carol's. Tell the throne room that the Blade's arrived. When Nemro shows, stay at least 5 meters back and don't come up unless you're called. One wrong move, and you're a pile of ash.
Send in Nemro and let's do this.
Just going over the rules. You've got a reputation, and we don't want any problems. Allow me to present Nemro the Hutt, the illustrious crime king of Jiguna.
Dodi buna buna, manchika bog nonis nemo.
It's more than you're worth, you pile of slime.
Yeta chupa chawa aita.
Not bad. Nemro, the idols here are real Orodium. The cloth looks like...
Manama Asha Bicho. Kipuna Malituta Odmishka Kabano Tasema. Ki Ubakiliwata Bangidanko Batogawata.
We have business to discuss.
Kunchuta Kasuyali Koira Tokanti Kong.
Of course, mighty Nemro.
Gumbajiji Gordin. Loli Makichi-san.
Kikuna mo. Uban choni alipa. Istin koto.
Gonchuta kasu yali koira tokanti kon.
Looks like your audience with Nemro is over. You'll have to forgive the interruption. I've been working for that hut since he killed my gang when I was 13. Trust me, you can't talk to him when he's like this.
Seems like your boss has some temper. Why stay with him?
Because Nimro's got power and smarts, along with his temper. I like things a little more orderly than he does, but I don't complain. We're having trouble with the Fathra clan, and it's getting to all of us. Fathra's out of line, but the Hutt cartel hasn't bothered to interfere.
I'm not sure I understand. Why would the Hutt cartel be involved?
According to cartel rules, Nemo and Fathra are supposed to stick to their territories, and Fathra's decided cartel rules don't apply. Now look, I need to work up new plans with security, and keep an eye on Tathlesian to keep him from suggesting anything stupid. In the meantime, you're a guest, and you've got our permission to do business here. You got the run of the palace, so I'll see you around.
Alright, we will leave our would-be anti-hero here, starting out in his journey with the Hutt Cartel as an undercover pirate, Red Blade. Hope you enjoyed watching, and stay tuned for the next episode.